60 years before an incensed Martin Luther produced his 95 Theses, the hymn you are hearing came into being. Born out of the teachings of the martyr Jan Hus and tempered by the factional violence and infighting of the ensuing Hussite wars, the Bohemian Brethren emerged, calling Christ's followers to a more biblical and compassionate way of life. It is no surprise that this, their first original hymn written in 1457 in the Bohemian language, was a prayer for unity within the body of Christ. In 1517, the same year that Luther's hammer rang out, a young Franciscan monk named Michael Weisse was expelled from Breslau, located in modern-day Poland, for embracing Luther's radical new ideas. A year later, he and several colleagues had joined with the Bohemian Brethren. After personal interaction with Reformation leaders of his day, he was greatly influenced by Huldreich Zwingli's teachings and rose to a position of authority within the unity of the Brethren, ministering to the German-speaking congregations. In 1531, he compiled and published Ein Neu Gesangbüchlein, a new little hymnal, the first hymnal of the Brethren in the German language. It was also the first hymnal to be organized by topics: times of the liturgical year, praise, prayer, times of the day, children's hymns, etc. He provided the translation of the hymn you are currently listening to and wrote the words to many of the selections in the hymnal, including the following hymn, heard here in its English translation, passed on to us by the spiritual grandchildren of the Brethren and the founders of the modern missionary movement, the Moravians. Again, its theme is the unity of the body of Christ.